the building's been allowed to deteriorate the way it has. You get pigeon dung at a certain level that the public doesn't really want to look at it. But it's hard to see past the degradation that's taken place over the last 20 or 30 years. Fifty years ago, the courthouse complex was viewed with affection. Now it's viewed with suspicion. People picket for all kinds of different causes in front of it. Everett had a major fire in August of 1909. August Franklin Heide, the architect, at the time that he was doing this in 1910, you'd had a whole resurrection of California mission style on the Pacific coast. Basically a white stucco with all the little detailing that makes it look like, you know, San Juan Capistrano or something. I can remember as a child that whenever we had visitors from out of town, like grandparents from back in the Midwest and stuff like that, they were always, you know, sort of taken over there, and we'd have our picture taken in front of it. And I don't know when that changed. Part of the problem, I think, may have had to do with that expansion. If you're in the Central Business District, and in the early days, before, say, in the 50s and most of the 60s, you could see the clock tower from all over, and that has I think that's a wonderful presence. I think it was interesting talking to the people who were in charge of what was going to happen to the campus over there, that I think they pretty much decided that I got the impression there wasn't really much affection on that committee for the building at all. And we were talking about the fact that, but it is recognized by the National Register as an historic building. I mean, that's a remarkable honor in itself. And you need to understand, maybe, or maybe you should try to understand the idea that that Spanish colonial influence is what, on the Pacific coast, you see reflected Spanish. On the East Coast, you see it reflected in English and French and Italian.